Hi again. So this topic is about the concept in chemistry that's very important for every chemical reaction when you need to calculate about the amount of substance involved in the reaction. We will need to calculate using the concept of number of mole of substance in the chemical reaction. So in this slide, we are going to learn about what is the definition of the mole in chemistry. And these are the learning objective again of chapter 1. We have learned about objective number 1 and number 2. Okay, so this is the objective number 3 for you to understand the relationship between mole. So we're going to learn the definition of mole first, and that is related to the number of particles. And from the number of particles and the mass, we're going to see the relationship between mass and mole. And that's going to bring us to the topic about the molar mass. And then number of mole of substance is also related to the volume of that substance in the gas state at a specific temperature and pressure condition. So this set of slides, we're going to learn about mole and number of particles. Okay, bring us to this chart again. This is chapter 1. We are going to learn about mole and chemical formula, but then we need to know first about atomic mass, which is used to calculate the molecular mass and the formula mass based on the chemical formula. So now this set of slide, we're going to learn about the mole, which is related again to number of particles and the mass in terms of the molar mass and the volume of gas at a specific or standard temperature and pressure. And this is the revision of atomic mass. What is it? We use average atomic mass, which of course we take it number from periodic table and use this to calculate molecular mass and formula mass. Hopefully every one of you can still remember and be able to calculate the molecular mass or formula mass once you are given the chemical formula of any compound. So now, the mole in chemistry, it's just a unit of how many of the things. Okay, for example, we have the unit that we are familiar with, like 1,000. Okay, and especially in Thai, that is around between 1,000 in Thai, we call it 1 lo. And the concept of mole is the same. Okay. 1,000 of things is equivalent to 12 things. So in this picture, 1,000 donuts would equal to 12 donuts. So you have to know this equivalence term. Dozen equal to 12. So if we are talking about 1,000 of pencil, it's gonna be 12 pencil. If we are talking about 1,000 of spoon, it's gonna be the same, 12 spoon. So a dozen is just the unit of how many of that thing. Things here can be anything, okay? Same thing for another unit that maybe some of you are familiar with, 1 ream. And this is used a lot for how many number of sheet of paper. So 1 ream is equivalent to 500 sheets of paper. Okay. Now back to chemistry concept. 1 mole of things. This definition, how many things is equivalent to 1 mole? The answer is this number. It looks quite complicated, okay? But every chemistry student has to know this number. 1 mole of things is equivalent to 6.022 times 10^23 things. A lot, right? 10 over 23 things. A lot. So if we're talking about one mole of carbon atoms, that would be equivalent to these many atoms. Okay? Nothing different. Okay. So again, here on this slide, the mole. And when we use the symbol or represent the unit mole, we use MOL. Okay? It is the unit of amount of substance in the international system of unit or the SI unit. It is defined as containing exactly this number of things, but it has too many digits here. So in short, we are going to use 6.022 times 10^23, and this is called Avogadro's number. And we use the chemists use the symbol N, A. Okay? So one mole of anything would have the same amount, which is the Avogadro's number. So one mole of donuts would be this many donuts. One mole of sheet of paper would be this many paper. And in chemistry, we have elementary unit like atoms, molecules, or ions. Okay? Whatever things that we are looking at when we're talking about one mole of that is gonna be the same. The same. You see? Okay? And in chemistry, now you have to be able to convert the number between mole and how many mole and how many. I use the word particles here because we can talk about many different elementary items, like we can talk about atoms, we can talk about ions, we can talk about molecules or other different things. So this particle word can be replaced by atoms. It can also be replaced by ions or molecules. Okay, and this is the concept, same concept as unit conversion. We need to know the equivalence. This is the equivalence. One mole equal to this many things. So we make this into ratio, depends on what unit we are, what unit we want. We want to convert from how many to mole, we will put the mole on top, okay? And then the final answer will be mole, because this particle will be cancel each other away, right? And if we want to convert back from mole to how many particles, we use the same equivalence, but this time the number of particles would be on top. Then mole can be divided or cancelled with mole. And then the answer would be how many particles. Okay? So calculation here is no different to the unit conversion. And I would like every one of you practice to show the calculation in this way. The benefit of this is that you know exactly what unit will be cancelled and what is the unit that are obtained at the end. So you know exactly that you calculated correctly or not. I will give you example after this. For example, here, the diagram to be followed is like this. From particle and mole from particle and mole. If you go this direction, you will use this ratio. Okay, if you go in the reverse direction like this, you will need this ratio, right? For example, if there are 100,000 atoms of boron, how many mole of boron are here? So we start with 100,000 atoms, okay? Because we are going from particles to mole. So we use this ratio, put it here, okay? And then the atom will be cancelled with the atom. We have number of mole as the result. Just do the calculation using calculator and you will get this answer. In the opposite way, okay, if there are 5 moles of barium atoms, if there are 5 moles of barium atom, how many atoms of barium are there? Convert number of mole to number of atoms. We're going from mole to particles. Okay, so we use this ratio over here. And mole cancel with mole. What we have is number of atoms. Can you follow? Hopefully you can. Okay? Then, here is time to practice. On this side, the left side, calculate number of mole. Okay? If we have this many atoms of helium, how many mole? If we have this many molecules of ammonia, how many mole? If we have this many atoms of iron, convert it to how many moles? If we have this 100 ion of potassium ion, convert it to how many moles? You see, the particles can be replaced with any of these terms. So the formula on this side, we want particles into mole, okay? So we will use this ratio. Just change the word particle to be what you are asking to convert from, all right? So it can be atoms, molecules, or ion. So on this side, it is asked you to calculate number of particles. Given you 100 mole of argon, giving you this many moles of nitrate ion, giving you 8.5 mole of iron atom, give you this mole of calcium ion. Okay, convert this mole into how many atoms of argon, how many ions of nitrate ion, how many atoms of iron, and how many ions, how many calcium ion. So we are doing this direction, okay? Use this ratio, okay? So everyone now go and do this exercise. After we know about the concept of mole, which equal to Avogadro's number, and in chemistry, we have many types of compounds, right? So then if we look at a specific compound and we want to know how many moles of the element in the compound, okay? We can do the same calculation. So this is the reminder. Compounds, what is it? What compound? Compounds are pure substances that formed by chemical combination of two or more different elements. In a compound, elements are bonded together in a fixed ratio, okay? Meaning that each molecule or formula unit of compound has a specific number of atoms of each element involved. All right. In a molecular compound, in an ionic compound. Okay, I give you the example already. Okay. How many? So for example, if we have this H2O for water. If we have one mole of water molecules, to answer this, how many mole of hydrogen atoms are there? How many mole of oxygen atoms are there? Okay, it is not very difficult, but I give you example with this concept first. So for example, we have a box of donuts here. In the box, we have the same, the simple one. We have three of these. We have one of these, and one of these. Okay, this is in one box. So if we have 12 boxes of these, if we have 12 boxes of these, how do I calculate how many of these, how many of these in total? Okay, what do we do? It's very easy, right? We know that each box, we have this many. Okay, so we have a total of 12 box. What do? We just then multiply, right? Multiply 12 with 3, 12 with 1, 12 with 1, and the same 12 with 1. So we have 36, 12, 12, and then 12. Easy, yeah? So if then we're trying to mimic the donuts into element, okay? Donut into element, okay? So if I represent this one molecule of covalent compound as CCl3OH. So in one molecule, I would have one carbon atom, three chlorine atoms, one oxygen atom, and one hydrogen atom. Okay? And in 12 boxes here, it is referred to one dozen. We remember that, right? Okay. So if we look at one dozen of boxes, one dozen of box of donuts, we're gonna have the same, right? We have this one in each box, 12 box or one dozen. We're gonna have this one dozen, this three dozen, this one dozen, and this one dozen. Okay? So if we turn one molecule into one mole, one molecule into one mole, rather than having just one atom, we're gonna have one mole atoms of carbon. We're gonna have three mole atoms of chlorine, one mole atoms of oxygen, and one mole atoms of hydrogen. How many carbon atoms exactly? One mole is Avogadro's number, right? So this will be 6.022 times 10^23 atom. Each, right? Okay. Can you see the similarity? So it is not difficult to find out if you have one mole of a compound. You can then get how many mole of each element by multiply the subscript with that number of mole, yeah? So, the mole of elements or ion in compound. We would just look at the formula and then look up the subscript. Yeah. So one mole of carbon dioxide molecule consists of one mole of carbon atom and two mole of oxygen atom. Easy. One mole of sodium nitrate. One mole of sodium nitrate. How many sodium ion? One mole sodium ion. How many nitrate ion? One mole nitrate ion. So what you have to recognize in the formula is what you are looking at. Okay. In the ionic compound, we can look at how many ions. Positive ion, negative ion, or we can look at atoms. So in this case, sodium nitrate, we would have one mole of sodium atom. Okay, sodium nitrate, we would have one mole. Sodium atom. One mole nitrogen atom. How many mole of oxygen? 3 mole oxygen atom. Yeah? So if we look at atoms, it will be like this. If we look at ion, it will be like this. Alright. Okay. Example. If you are given a formula of sucrose, okay, and this sucrose you have 0.25 moles. 0.25 mole. Find the number of moles of each element. So easy, right? From the formula here, one mole of sucrose, it consists of 12 mole of carbon. It consists of 22 moles of hydrogen and 11 moles of oxygen. So we can create the ratio for calculate like this. Calculate mole of carbon, 0.25 mole of sucrose times this ratio. There is 12 mole of carbon for every 1 mole of sucrose. And this is how you see it. There are 12 mole of carbon for every 1 mole of sucrose. So if we have 0.25 mole of sucrose, how many mole of carbon atom? So we cancel this. 12 times 0.25, we get 3 mole of carbon. Same thing for hydrogen. Use different ratio. Same thing for oxygen with different ratio. And then you get all the answer. You may think that, why do I have to write it in ratio like this? Why can't I just 0.25 multiply by 0.25 multiply by 12? Yeah, you can do that. But in this pattern, you will know what you're looking at exactly, and then the unit can be cancelled away. Think of this calculation in the same way of unit conversion and you will be safe. Okay, another example. For the formula of sodium carbonate. Sodium carbonate. So subscript 2 here mean you have each formula, we have 2 sodium ion. And we have 1 carbonate ion. Okay? 1 carbonate ion. Right? So if you are asked, how many mole of sodium ion are there in 5 mole of sodium carbonate? So you set up the calculation like this. For each mole of sodium carbonate, we have 2 mole of sodium ion. Multiply with the given 5 mole. And then mole of sodium carbonate divide sodium carbonate. We have 10 mole of sodium ion. If you are asked how many mole of carbonate ion, you set up the formula. For every 1 mole sodium carbonate, we have 1 mole carbonate ion. Multiply that with the given number 5 mole. Okay? And then the last one, we didn't show anything about oxygen here yet. Okay? So you have to find out how many mole of oxygen atom, how many mole of oxygen atom. So for each mole of sodium carbonate, how many mole of oxygen? You get the answer 3. Okay, 3. So we put in 3 here. 3 mole of oxygen. Okay, and then this cancel with this. 3 times 5 is 15 mole of oxygen. Not difficult, right? Make it into how many atoms or how many ion exactly. So we use the same concept. Convert mole. Now we know how many mole of each element in the compound. If you are asked how many atoms exactly or how many ion exactly, we convert mole into particles using Avogadro's number. What is the number? 6.022 times 1023 particle per 1 mole. Yeah? Okay. So, let's see. Okay, carbon dioxide, 1 molecule. If we look at 1 molecule, we have 1 atom of carbon, 2 atoms of oxygen. If we look at 1 mole of this carbon dioxide molecule, we're gonna have 1 mole of carbon atom. We're gonna have 2 moles of oxygen atoms. So 1 mole of carbon atoms is equal to how many atoms times that with Avogadro's number. Okay? So we can use 6.02 or 6.022, right? And that multiply 2 moles with this Avogadro's number for oxygen atom. So if you are asked to calculate number of oxygen in 1 mole of carbon dioxide, you can set up calculation like this. Okay? Convert 1 mole of carbon dioxide to how many mole of oxygen first. And this is cancelled out. And then convert number of mole of oxygen to atoms of oxygen. Okay, by this Avogadro's number, that is cancelled away. So this is your final answer. Alright. What I ask of you is practice to set up calculation in this way. Make sure that the unit are cancelled away and you are left with what you are asked for. Atoms of oxygen, you are asked for number atoms of oxygen. Okay. Another example, 1 mole of carbon dioxide molecules. You have this Avogadro's number of molecules of carbon dioxide. Okay, so question 1. How many atoms of carbon? How many atoms of carbon are there in 15 moles of carbon dioxide? Start with 15 mole carbon dioxide. How many mole of carbon first? In the formula, every 1 mole of carbon dioxide, we have 1 mole of carbon. Okay, then this step we get 15 mole of carbon atom. Convert mole of carbon atoms into exactly how many atoms using Avogadro's number. Okay, and this cancel away. And you get this final answer. Alright, and then second question, how many atoms of oxygen are there in 30 moles of carbon dioxide? So this 30 mole of carbon dioxide will be your starting point. Okay, for every 1 mole of carbon dioxide, we have 2 moles of oxygen from the formula, right? And this cancel. And then change mole of oxygen into how many atoms? Multiply by Avogadro's number. And that you get final answer. It might be, it might look complicated and you have to write down many things. And most students only write number. Okay, most students only write number without state exactly what is this number belong to. And then it might lead to a wrong calculation afterward. So again, I repeat many times that it is better for you to write number followed by unit of substance, so that more carbon dioxide cancel with more carbon dioxide, more carbon cancel with more carbon. Okay, because later on in chapter 3, we're going to use the same concept, but then you have to use relationship between different substances. Until then, you'll be happy or what's it called? You will practice enough to be able to set up the formula and cancel unit, and then you'll be good. So please try to set up the calculation in this way. Okay. Finally, again, this is your practice exercise. Complete it and submit it in Google Classroom. Have a good day. Bye-bye.